Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will cover the Andhra Pradesh current affairs for 2019. This is set 1 and I will try to bring as many sets as possible and I will try to be as comprehensive as possible. These current affairs are prepared keeping in mind the requirements of APPSC exam but also other exams, Group C, D, you know, other exams of Andhra, and these will be useful in all the state exams. So let's start set 1. Now you can follow me on social media also. This is my Instagram ID, Tireless Soul. You can also follow me on Facebook. Now, if you want the PDF of this video, then please visit our website, which is studyiq.com. Studyiq.com is the website that you have to visit. Now, there is a new railway zone for Andhra Pradesh. So remember that there were 17 railway zones in India, and now one latest has been added. So the total number of railway zones in India has become 18. Clear? So new railway zone was announced by the Railway Minister Piyush Goyal. The name that they have given to it is called Southern Coast Railway. Southern Coast Railway. Clear? The headquarter of this new railway zone will be in Visakhapatnam. It will be the 18th railway zone of India. Which all divisions will be there in this zone? So a zone is always divided into divisions. And in this case, there will be three main division: Vijayawada, Guntur and Guntakal. Guntur, Guntakal and Vijayawada. Guntur is famous for the tobacco cultivation. In fact, the headquarter of Tobacco Board of India is also in Guntur, Vijayawada and Guntakal. It will also have one section of the Voltaire Rail Division also. Now remember, under item 8 of schedule 13 that corresponds to infrastructure in the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act, Indian Railways was required to examine the feasibility of establishing a new railway zone in Andhra. Clear or not clear? So under item 8 of schedule 13 of the AP Reorganization Act, and therefore the railway ministry, they thought it is feasible and they announced the new railway zone for Andhra. Now, a 3-day flamingo festival was celebrated in the Pulikat Lake of Andhra. Okay, Pulikat Lake, very important. Flamingo is a bird, you know, migratory bird. So, Flamingo Bird Festival took place from January the 17th. It started from January 17th at these places: Sulurpeta, BV Palem and Nelapattui. And Flamingo Festival, it's a 12-year long tradition of this region. Clear? The highlight of this festival is the sight of the colorful migratory birds from Siberia that visit the region for nesting and breeding. So these flamingo birds, they come to Andhra Pradesh all the way from Siberia and they can be spotted in Pulikat Lake. Now Andhra Pradesh has got their own separate high court from 1st of January. Clear? From 1st of January they have got their separate high court and it has been set up in Amaravati. Clear? In Amaravati. So this high court will be set up in Justice City in Amaravati, which is the new capital of Andhra Pradesh. Earlier Hyderabad High Court was there, but now it has been given to Telangana. So Andhra Pradesh, they wanted their own high court, which they have established in Justice City in Amaravati. And Vikram Nath has been appointed as the first Chief Justice of the new Andhra Pradesh High Court. Clear? Vikram Nath is the first Chief Justice of Andhra Pradesh High Court. Okay, let's take an MCQ. Which of the following has been named as the state animal of Andhra Pradesh? The state animal of Andhra Pradesh was declared in 2018 and okay, it is black buck. Black buck. So remember, 2014 we had the bifurcation of Andhra, thereby creating a separate Telangana, 29th state of India. Clear? Now the state bird of undivided Andhra. Okay, the state bird, let me draw undivided Andhra here. This is undivided Andhra, roughly, okay. So, of undivided Andhra, it was Indian roller or palapitta. It was the state bird. Indian roller or palapitta, as it is called in the local language. This has been changed to Ramachilluka. So, now Andhra Pradesh, the state bird is Ramachilluka. In English, we call it rose-ringed parakeet. This is the rose-ringed parakeet. This is the state bird of Andhra, the new one. The old one was palapitta. Palapitta is now the state bird of Telangana, Odisha and Karnataka. Clear? So this is Palapitta or the Indian roller. It is retained by Telangana as the state bird. And also it is the state bird of Odisha and Karnataka. If I talk about the state animal, then the government of Andhra Pradesh, they have retained black buck. Because earlier also, undivided Andhra Pradesh, black buck was the state animal. Clear? Undivided Andhra Pradesh, black buck. This is black buck. It was the state animal of Andhra. So even after Telangana was separated, the residual Andhra, they have retained black buck. So black buck is still the animal, state animal. And in local language, it is called Krishna Jinka. Krishna Jinka. Now Telangana, they adopted a new state animal, which is called simply Jinka or spotted deer. So this is Jinka and this is Krishna Jinka. So please don't confuse between the two. This is called spotted deer or Jinka. It is the state animal of Telangana. Now let's talk about state tree. Okay. So undivided Andhra Pradesh had neem as the state tree. Clear? Undivided Andhra Pradesh, the state tree was neem. And the new Andhra Pradesh also, neem is retained. Clear? So neem still is the state tree of Andhra. But the government of Telangana, they changed. Okay. So they dropped Vepa Chettu or neem tree and they have adopted Jami Chettu. So this tree is called Jami Chettu. Clear? Prosopsis cinerea. This is now the new state tree of Telangana. It has cultural significance in the region. Clear? So Andhra neem, Telangana, Prosopsis cinerea. Now this is the most interesting one, the flower. Okay, and why I say interesting is because both have changed. Andhra, the new Andhra, and Telangana, they both have changed the old state flower. So undivided Andhra Pradesh, they had water lily or kaluva as the state flower. Okay, water lily or kaluva. Clear? But now Andhra and Telangana, they both have dropped it. They both have done away with it. Clear? So the new state flower of Andhra is jasmine, because jasmine is grown commercially in Guntur, Prakasam, Kurnool, Kadapa, Anantapur and Chittur districts. And what about Telangana? So Telangana have adopted this new state flower, which is called Tangidi Puvvu. Tangidi Puvvu. The scientific name is Sena Auriculata. And why only this flower? Because in Telangana there is a very famous festival which is called Batukamma. So in Batukamma, the floral festival, these flowers are used widely. Clear? So Andhra jasmine, Telangana Tangidi Puvvu. Now just because it becomes easier for you, I have put a table here and therefore it will be much easier for you. Telangana state animal is Jinka or spotted deer, Andhra black buck. Telangana state bird is Indian roller or Palapitta, Andhra is Rama Chilluka. Telangana state tree is Jami Chettu and Andhra it is neem. Okay. And of course flower, Tangidi Puvvu for Telangana and jasmine for Andhra. Clear? The water lily is not there in now Telangana or Andhra. Now let's take a look at another thing from Andhra, which is the Samba Masuri rice. So Samba Masuri rice is widely grown in Andhra. Clear? And it has always been plagued by this bacterial blight disease. Clear? Bacterial blight disease is caused by organism called Xanthomonas oryzae. Xanthomonas oryzae. It can lead to yield losses up to 50%. 50% of the rice, that is the Samba Masuri rice of Andhra, can get destroyed because of the bacterial blight. Clear? So bacterial blight is one of the most destructive diseases of rice plant. Clear? And this disease was first found in Japan in 1884. Samba Masuri rice is also called BPT 5204. Now remember, an improved Samba Masuri, that is a diabetic friendly rice variety, has been developed jointly by CSIR, CCMB and ICAR, Indian Council of Agriculture Research. Clear? So this variety is bacterial blight resistant and also diabetic friendly. So it is an improved variety of Samba Masuri rice of Andhra Pradesh. Now let's talk about Kapu reservation in Andhra. Right? So Kapu, so in Andhra you have Kapu, Naidus, Reddies, all these are dominant communities, right? So Andhra Pradesh government, they have passed two separate bills in the Andhra Assembly to provide 5% reservation out of the total 10% reservation of the economically weaker section to Kapus and the remaining 5% for the EWS. So basically earlier what happened was Andhra Pradesh, they gave reservation to Kapu, but the government refused it. Okay. And also they cannot cross the 50% state limit. Supreme Court has set a limit of 50%. In any state of India, this limit cannot be crossed. But now the central government has brought another legislation. You can provide 10% reservation to those upper caste which are economically weaker. And after that, the Andhra Pradesh has passed two bills. Clear? Thereby giving 5% reservation to Kapus and another 5% to the upper caste who are economically weaker. Clear? Economically weaker section or EWS. And it has been signed now by the governor. Therefore, it has become an act. Now, Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu, he has unveiled scheme for marginalized Brahmins. Okay, marginalized Brahmin. Remember, Andhra Pradesh is the first state in India to have a Brahmin corporation. Clear? And what is the job of this Brahmin corporation? It is to basically devise new policies, new schemes for the upliftment of the Brahmins in Andhra. Clear? So, the Brahmin youth, they are also being given subsidy. If they want to start driving taxi, then they will have to pay only 10% of the on-road price of the car. Clear? And these cars are diesel run. Clear? So they were given this car, Maruti Suzuki Swift Desire. And only 10% of the cost has to be borne by the Brahmin youth. Rest will be paid by the government if he is willing to start a taxi. Also remember, the Andhra cabinet has also decided to provide an annual cash benefit of 10,000 per acre to farmers. Okay, 10K per acre to farmer. And the old age pension has been doubled. So earlier it was 1,000 per month. Now it has been increased to 2,000 per month. This was a recent cabinet decision. Also, Andhra has also decided to write off life tax for tractors and auto rickshaws. Now life tax will not be required to be paid by the tractor and rickshaw owners. Insofar as the schemes for Brahmins are concerned, the Andhra Pradesh has lot of schemes for Brahmins, lot of subsidies. So let's quickly take a look at the important schemes for Brahmins. First is the Bhargav scheme. Bhargav scheme is to catalyze, energize and strengthen the efforts of individuals or group of individual, clear, an organization representing Brahmin community. It is matching grant. Bhargav scheme. Then we have Vedic education, which is called Vedavyasa scheme. It is for the students of Brahmin community who are pursuing full-time Vedic education. Then we have Gayatri scheme for academic excellence to recognize the toppers in the Brahmin community at the school level, college level, university level. Then we have Vashishta scheme for coaching to encourage the Brahmin students succeed in competitive exams by giving them coaching from approved institutions. Then we have Dronacharya scheme for skill development to develop the skills in the unemployed Brahmin youth to make them more industry ready. Then we have Kalyanamastu Pathakam to encourage Vedic culture, clear, to encourage Vedic culture for the bride who is marrying to a Brahmin boy, clear. And then we have a Bharati scheme for academic education to encourage the Brahmin students continue their academic education by providing one-time financial assistance under the Bharati scheme. Then we have Kashyap scheme. This is for the poor orphan children, poor orphan Brahmin youth, clear, or differently abled or widows, destitute poor women and elderly Brahmin to meet their food and shelter expenses. Kashyap scheme. It's a monthly pension scheme. Then we have funeral expense also, which is Garuda scheme, to provide financial assistance for funeral expenses of a deceased Brahmin, clear, if the family has no other means to earn. Then we have entrepreneurship scheme, which is called Chanakya scheme, to encourage the economically weaker Brahmin entrepreneur to set up micro enterprises or to start their new venture, to provide them seed capital, for example. Clear? Now, the Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu, he has also launched Bhu Seva and Bhu Dar. Okay, Bhu basically means land, L-A-N-D. Clear? Land. So, Bhu Dar is developed with integration of technology and would end litigation and corruption in land records. Clear? What about Bhuseva? Bhuseva will provide you the information related to all the transactions of a particular land or property in a single source. Bhudar is basically a 11 digit unique number. It's a 11 digit unique identification code. It will be assigned to each agriculture land holding, whether it is rural or urban, doesn't matter. Clear? Also, geotagging and georeference will be introduced to enable the people to view the details of their land through satellite mapping. The state government will also provide security to the land property of the people. Bhudar will make the records very transparent, clear. It would be very convenient now to retrieve the revenue records. Earlier, there used to be heaps of files and it was very difficult to get to a land record. But with Bhudar portal, it will become very easy. Clear? Now, K. Sivareddy, he has got Saraswati Samman. Saraswati Samman is one of the highest recognitions in Indian literature. Clear? So, Telugu famous poet K. Sivareddy, he will be given Saraswati Samman for his collection of poems called Pakkaki Oti Jilait. Okay? Which means in English, turning aside while lying down. Turning aside while lying down. And his name is K. Sivareddy. For his Telugu collection of poems called this. Okay. Now, this award, Saraswati Samman, was started by K.K. Birla Foundation. It is given annually for outstanding work in the field of Indian languages. Clear? And remember, K. Sivareddy was from Guntur. He was born in Guntur. Let's talk about Nara Lokesh. Nara Lokesh is the son of Chandrababu Naidu, the chief minister. But more importantly, he is also the IT minister, information technology minister. He has been included in the Young Global Leaders list by the World Economic Forum. Young Global Leaders list. Total 127 people were there from all over the world and he was one of them. Clear? And Nara Lokesh is the minister of information technology, electronics and communication in Andhra Pradesh. Now remember the central government, they made amendment to the National Institute of Design Act 2014. There will be four new NIDs that will be set up. National Institute of Design, one will be in Andhra. So these are the four new NIDs. You must have heard about the National Institute of Design in Ahmedabad. But now there will be more National Institute of Design that will be opened up. So in Amravati in Andhra, in Jorhat in Assam, in Bhopal in Madhya Pradesh and Kurukshetra in Haryana. Clear? So, we will have a NID in Amravati also. Okay, let me ask you a question. The Polavaram irrigation project was declared as a national project under which section of the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act of 2014? Polavaram irrigation project, right? So, just as Andhra has Polavaram, Telangana has Kaleshwaram project. Kaleshwaram is a very ambitious project of the government of Telangana. Clear? It is section 90. Section 90 of the AP Reorganization Act. Now remember, the first district cooling system of India will come up in Amravati. District cooling system, they produce chilled water, steam or hot water at a central plant and then they pipe that energy out to buildings for air conditioning. What it does is, it makes the need for air conditioner, boiler or chiller, etc. redundant. Clear? Chillers, ACs are not required, they consume lot of energy. Instead, district cooling system is used and first time in India it has been introduced in Amravati. These are very efficient. They consume only 50% of the energy that a chiller or a AC will use. Clear? So it is more environment friendly also and the carbon footprint is also reduced. So that was the part 1. I will bring many more videos and of course there are a lot of current affairs of Andhra Pradesh. Like for example, Swachh Dhara initiative has started recently. There is eRaitu app that was launched. Lot and lot of current affairs I will cover in the coming videos. So this was only set 1. If you liked and enjoyed the video, do share with your friends from Andhra. Then I will be encouraged to bring more state current affairs for all of you. And do follow me on social media also for all the updates. And one more thing, yeah, I will cover there were some white papers which were released by the government of Andhra. I will cover these also in detail for your APPSC mains. And this is my social media, facebook.com/GauravGargEducation. You can also follow me on Instagram, available on Tireless Soul. See you, take care, God bless, goodbye.